Here we are, Show and Go 2.0. Got a guest in this one. We're in the office, new studio. Got our little core style set up here. Jackson's in Auckland. He's obviously not here. We've got Bocco, Louis Bocco. What's going on, brother?
What's happening? It said Louis Bockos, but...
Bockos. I got it wrong, did I?
Nah, you're all right. I get that confused a lot, so...
Yeah.
I don't blame you, but yeah.
Tell everyone on the Show and Go what you do, man.
So my name's Bocco, or Louis, or Bocco. That's my nickname. I run an Instagram page called Bocco6, where I put rugby highlights up for junior talent or some of the talent that just, you know, haven't been discovered yet. So give them a bit of a platform to, you know... publicize them a bit and
gun. Well, Bocco's one of the guys that reached out to me early on in my content creating days when I first started at YKTR, offered a hand, used to cut Ice's vlogs every now, not the vlogs, it was the podcast.
So
Ice's used a bit of Bocco's editing skills, but yeah, if you see his content on Instagram, it's like grouse, like it's just the gun, man. And all the young guns that are coming through, they all want to be on your page and whatnot. And that's why I wanted to get you on, because you've got such a little foresight into the talent in rugby league that's coming through. Like, what's the bloke that just went to Rugby Australia? Swali, is that his name?
Yeah, Joseph Swali.
Yeah.
I don't think he's officially signed to Rugby Australia yet. I think there's talks about it.
Because you know a bit of mail on that, don't you?
Yeah, a little bit. So I know, obviously, Joseph Swali's big name. Yeah. I've been talking him up for a while now. I put a video out last year about him. So, yeah, he's at Rabbitohs currently. They've offered him 1.2 million he's 16 years old,
yeah,
and he can't sign a rugby league contract till he's 17.
Yeah, we just had McKinnon in for Ice Project, and he was saying, like, he's actually a mad follower of your page, eh?
Yeah, Alex McKinnon,
because he's a junior talent scout for the night. So every video you put, I was like, yeah, I've seen that kid play for ages, and I don't know, like, I don't want to go into it too much, but he showed us some of the, like, their recruiting process, and he's a very analytical guy,
yeah, man.
And all the shit behind the scenes that he does, like player ratings, it's all through spreadsheets and stuff. Correct. Proper Moneyball stuff, eh?
Yeah.
For all the young kids that are coming through.
Yeah, so he would have had an eye on Swali as obviously.
Yeah, sure.
At nights. But this kid's unreal, man. Like, I see a lot of people comparing him to Greg Inglis or Kalen Ponga, like saying he's a mix. Yeah. But, man,
caption on Insta, on the old YKTR Sports.
He's going to be himself. Like,
yeah.
He'll make a name for himself. He'll be the first Joseph Swali. So,
it's a catchy name too.
Yeah. Bro, he's so I don't know if you know much about, like, the first 15 rugby system.
Little bit.
So it's pretty big, like... It's almost like, I wouldn't say like professional first grade for rugby, but...
Oh, you want to make the first 15.
Man, it's 100. A high standard to be first 15. And this kid was playing first 15 at 14 years old.
That's good.
So think about a 14-year-old playing against like 18-year-olds.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And he's tearing up as well. Like, mind you, he's not just like on the bench like coming on.
He's killing it. He's a big unit. How tall is he?
Dude, he's 6'5", and I think he's about 96 kilos.
Fuck. Yeah, no wonder he's playing up, eh?
Yeah, I think the thing that people are holding him in the highest regard is his confidence.
Yeah.
He's like willing to take on any defense, and I think his defense as well.
Yeah.
That's being like held in a very high regard. Like, people are saying he's just willing. He loves contact.
Yeah.
By the sounds of it. And if you watch his highlights as well, yeah, he's putting all his shots.
Tearing, and, you know, dude, his shots, everything.
He's killing it. So... obviously, we want him to stay in NRL, stay in rugby league, but Rugby Australia's, they've thrown a deal at him, supposedly.
Big bag, huge bag.
Massive for a 16-year-old kid.
Yeah.
Massive, but I guess it sort of goes to show, like, how high he's being held.
100.
Yeah.
Well, I wanted to dive in as a creative myself, sort of your creative process and, like, your videos are gone. Obviously, you've shown me a little bit of your editing process, helped me out fucking heaps, little packages and whatnot. But from, like, when you're getting a highlights video, how are you getting your hands on the content? And, like, people obviously are mad keen to get on your page. How does that work? Like, if I'm a little young kid playing footy at the moment, how do I get on Bocco?
Yeah, so a lot of kids just DM me their highlights, so... Obviously, Instagram.
Have you seen some duds, like some average?
Mate, you get your good and your bad, but like my job is to make the bad look as good as possible.
Yeah.
So if like, especially when kids are filming it off their phone,
yeah,
and the quality's not good, but the highlight could be gun.
Yeah.
So you've got to sort of make it work. And I've tried it before and it's worked, like it still pulls through. But
Because most kids are getting taped. Like, when I played footy under 16s, we were getting taped and watching it.
Mate, all my games got taped as well, but I don't know the footage.
Have you got your own? Oh, lost the footage, huh?
Mate, I was a gun back in the day. Nah. Well, I took myself up. But that's the easiest way. Just send them through on DM. Yeah. And I usually tell the kids to email them as well. So I've
got like a Dropbox or something like that?
Yeah, yeah. Just so the quality stays good. Because if you're sending them through DMs on Instagram, it's crap.
Yeah, it all downscales it.
Yeah, I'll make it work, but... Yeah. You know, it's easier if you email it. And then, I'll cut it up. I'll send it back. And then, you know, if all's happy with it, I'll make sure the kids don't want, like, if they don't want some certain things in it, I'll take it out. Yeah. If they want more things in it, I'll put it in.
Yeah, so if they've whacked a bloke, they want that repeat and the big effects and shit
exactly.
like that.
So I'll work through them with changes. But, you know, 9 times out of 10, they're pretty happy with it. Yeah. And then, I'll chuck it up, you know, try to get it as many views as possible, you know, get their name out there. So... that's sort of the process behind it, yeah.
Have you, like, how many do you like to punch out a month? Like, you've had a bit of time off at the moment with everything that's going on with COVID. And what's, like, how many, you like, one a week? That's normally your thing at the moment?
I try to pump out 3. So, I don't know if you've seen, but I've had the problems with Instagram.
Yeah, man, you're DMing too many chicks, bro. No, you know, you got to miss her. I can't do that.
But, no, I got action block, but I try to do 3 times a week. So, I do... Monday, Wednesday, Friday. That's like my schedule.
Yeah.
If I can't do one of those days, I'll still try to pump it out maybe Thursday or a Tuesday. Yeah. Obviously, during the week's the best period 100. To post. Weekends are a bit tougher because people are on Instagram at different times. At least during the week, you know, people go on after 3 o'clock after school finishes or after 5 o'clock after work finishes. So that's a cool little insight into when to post on the Instagram. Mm. And then after like 7 o'clock when people have dinner and stuff, they're also on. So I try to post around 8 o'clock. Or 9 o'clock even.
We try and do the same thing, but ice is just so bang post, bang post, bang post.
Well, that works.
We'll double, triple sometimes.
Yeah.
Depends on like what we're doing. Like if I know I'm editing, I don't want to think about scheduling or anything. I'll just punch out a few, but definitely like similar insights. Like after 3 o'clock, that 5 o'clock where people are on buses and trains coming home from work and shit like that.
You want to find that sweet spot.
And you're, if you've obviously got a lot of kids that would follow you as well. Like your demo, what's your stats? Like 13 to 18 be huge, eh?
Yeah, 13 to 18. And even 18 to, is it 35 or 25?
Yeah.
That's big too.
Yeah.
It's funny because I've got like a weird female audience, but I don't know if that's just.
Oh,
like,
no.
I don't know if that's just like kids on their mum's account.
Yeah. Oh, that could be a thing, eh?
That's what I sort of thought about. It's like 30%.
Even better.
Nah. That's bad, man. Nah, but like, that's sort of my insights.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, that's the best time to post. But at NRL, we post all throughout the day as well. Obviously on a larger scale because it's a big corporation.
Yeah,
but
well, that's I didn't even brought that up. Yeah, you do a bit of work with the NRL. And that's a pretty cool story. Like you're at school.
Yeah.
And then you were working at NRL nighttime stuff. Yeah. Tell that story, man. It's gone.
Walk you through it. So back in 2016 I started just as like a fan, like maybe fan edits and stuff. There's heaps of pages out there you'll see, but I was one of those pages originally. And I was doing it, and I think February 2017, I still remember, I had my Instagram account, had about 10,000 followers at the time, I think. And I had my email in my bio, and this guy DM'd me from the NRL, and he's like, "Hey, like, we want to get you to do some work experience for us."
Yeah, right.
I was like, "This is gross. Like, this is so good."
100.
But I was in business studies at the time, so I was in class at school. I get this email. I'm like showing all my mates. I'm like, "Boys, like,
what's
come look
going
at this."
on here?
My teacher's like to me, like, "Well, that's enough." Like, my teacher.
Yeah.
My teacher at the time, I was a bit of a naughty boy at school. Like,
yeah,
you know, I'll talk through class and stuff. Like, not good, but she threw me out of the class for showing all the boys that email. Shout out Miss Lyon.
What's up, Miss Lyon?
But I replied to him. I got back to him.
Yeah.
I didn't hear for about a month. Come March, he's gone to me. We want to do a Rabbitohs Roosters hype up video before the game. Oh, the old rivalry. So I was like, I punched it out.
Yeah.
Got good feedback on it. And then ever since then, bro, I kept doing it. Come September, I was like at the Dally M Awards. Like, I was 16 at the time. So I was in year 11 at school.
Yeah.
I was doing even some videos during lunchtime. Like I'd go to the library, I'd cut up videos and send them back to NRL.
That's a hustle, bro.
Because like school internet was fast too. Yeah. So I pump it out at school. I'm not in class.
Shout out, Miss.
Yeah, shout out, Miss Lyon. So I got the opportunity to go Dally M's. I got opportunity to go to the grand final and. That 2017 year, man, that was so awesome.
Yeah.
Especially as a young kid. And
are you cutting the Twitter clips and because they're pretty quick in the NRL. So if there's a try, it'll move pretty quickly straight into the Twitter.
Well, it's me and our social media team there. There's about 6 of us. But yeah, we've got, you know, our programs at work that we cover the games live on Twitter. So we'll pump the full time posts out, pump like pre-game matchups.
Using all our lingo, eh?
Yeah, yeah.
We've seen that.
Doozy. Isaac trademarked it the next week.
Laters. Yeah, no, that's a good giggle.
Yeah. But yeah, I got put on as a casual and then I got put on full time last year in November. So I started uni last year and that's why they didn't put me on at the start of last year.
Yeah, right.
But dropped out of uni, so... You know, college dropout, Kanye West.
What's up? He's gone crazy. Did you see him go yesterday?
Yeah, bro.
I just happened to jump on Twitter and it was literally at the moment he's done his first tweet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's calling...
Kim Kardashian now.
Yeah, everyone. I wanted a divorce. When do you want Meek Mill, like, shit like that?
I was reading a bit of backstory, eh? So did you see the Meek Mill tweets?
Nah, did he tweet it yesterday as well?
Yeah, apparently back in 2018, Kim Kardashian and Meek Mill had like some prison reform.
Yeah, meeting. That's it. That's what Kanye was tweeting.
And
yeah,
it's like implied that Kim Kardashian asked Meek Mill for like an affair or something. And Meek Mill denied it, told Kanye. Kanye didn't believe him. And then Meek Mill's gone on a song. There's like some lyrics that people have found.
Subliminal
and,
shit.
Yeah, it's like talking about the situation.
Yeah, right.
And there's this whole conspiracy that apparently Drake might have got with Kim Kardashian, but...
Drizzy, but well, that was one of the tweets yesterday as well. He's like,
he just goes Drake and he's
doing these ones. Like, that's hectic. It was crazy. I was actually texting someone at the time, and it's like crazy, like someone in the culture can just stop everything.
Yeah,
because the amount of content that comes, like your complexes,
memes, and
all
that,
those accounts, everything off the back. I just hope the bloke's all right, man. It can't be in a good headspace.
I'm a massive
with all that
Kanye
shit,
fan
bro.
Too.
Same.
I've been following him since the Pablo era, like properly.
Yeah.
Like I remember Pablo coming out and him adding the new song on Saint Pablo. Yeah. Ever since then, bro.
I'm a bit older than you, bro.
Yeah.
I was at the. It was out in 07 at Acer Arena back in the day.
Oh, you seen him live?
Yeah, I was like from here to where the fridge is, bro.
Yeah.
I was right at the front. Wow. Just grouse. It would had Bone Thugs and Harmony supporting him.
Yeah.
And who was the other bloke? Oh, I can't remember.
Have you done your fair share of concerts?
Like, concerts?
Yeah.
I was saying that the other day. The last concert I went to was fucking, what was it? Bieber back in 07.
Justin Bieber.
Yeah, that's man. That's it, man.
Yeah.
I need to go to more. Like,
was that Baby Days?
No, bro. That was the last album, whenever that was.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, I used to go all the time, like back when on George Street opposite the movies.
Yeah.
I used to be like mad into like Triple J and all that sort of music, and like go to all those little bit. I went to Flume's first concert.
Oh, really?
It was at Oxford.
He's a Northern Beaches boy.
Yeah. Grew up in Manly.
Yeah.
So Flume's first concert, that was off its head, man. Yeah. It was just in little Oxford Art Factory. Have you ever been in there?
Nah.
Bro, a little mad little venue. And he was supporting his band Grafton Primary.
Yeah.
Comes back after. And that's when I was sort of like dabbling in music, making music. So I had like a synth and everything at home and all the setup. Yeah. And I literally bought him a beer and we like spoke about like how he makes his music. Yeah.
That's mad.
First concert. It's my little claim to fame. So a bit of a name drop. There we go. Shout out Flume, bro.
Come in
for the show and go, man. What are you doing? Nah, to jump back into the footy stuff, bro.
Yeah.
Who's your team? I don't know.
I'm a Gold Coast Titans.
Oh, bro.
Not many people will know that. Well, when I tell people that, they're like, why?
Yeah, why? You're a Sydney boy, huh?
Yeah, so Dad's a massive Manly fan. I grew up a Manly fan. Yeah. I went to 08 Grand Final, and then the next year I changed to the Titans.
Yeah.
I don't know why. I think I like their colours and their new team on the block.
Yeah, fair enough.
Scotty Prince was playing back then. Preston Campbell. I love those.
Matty Rogers had left well by then, eh?
I think he was still there. But yeah, he was exciting. They were all exciting. Preston Campbell, especially, man. I used to love the step, the speed. Tiny bloke too. Yeah,
100%.
On the line, but I'm a Titans fan. Hey, better than being a Manly fan.
Yeah. We'll see.
Yeah.
Well, I reckon that's where we wrap up the show and go for today. Bocco, little 20-minute eps. That's what we're all about here, in and out of the podcast. But yeah, thanks for tuning in. New model. Let us know in the comments if you like it. Hit the subscribe button. Yeah. I never say that on the Zoom one, but
subscribe. Jump
on, hit that subscribe button. I've got Footy Companion tonight, so tune in for that. I don't know if I'll get this up before. We'll see how we go. Bocco, you want to edit it, bro? Yeah, you can edit it.
Put me in.
Yeah, that's your fee, bro. All right, thanks, bro.
Thanks, mate.
Oh, that was fucking good, eh?